Good afternoon, class 12 students. Once again, we continue with the biology chapter 1 of reproduction in organisms. And children, we see here that in video 3 we had studied about the subaerial stems, modifications of 4 types of these subaerial stems. Then we saw root modifications, leaf and bulbil modifications. We studied artificial vegetative propagation and also the advantages of vegetative propagation. And we studied about disadvantages of vegetative propagation. We studied about the characteristics and importance of sexual reproduction, etc. Now, today we continue with some more information on sexual reproduction, which is important for organisms. In all organisms, both plants and animals, they have hormones which are responsible for transition between the 3 phases. And we had studied about these 3 phases, children, that these 3 phases in reproduction are very, very important. And these 3 phases that we studied about are the vegetative, the reproductive, and the senescent phases, children. And so we see interaction between hormones and certain environmental factors. They regulate the reproductive processes. So reproduction is regulated between hormones and certain environmental factors in various organisms. And we see that there are several things that are observed during reproduction, like puberty, or we can say the reproductive organs, they develop and mature, which is called puberty in animals, children. Then in higher plants, we see when flowers begin to appear, it indicates the sexual maturity of the higher plant. And there are 2 types of flowering plants that are there, and these are sexually oriented plants, like monocarpy plants, where flowers only once in their lifetime comes out. Example, annuals like wheat, rice, etc., or biennials for 2 years. Plants like carrot, radish, and in perennials for many, many years. Also few plants like China rose, etc. Then we see polycarpic plants flower more than once in their lifespan. Unlike the monocarpic, the polycarpic plants, children, they flower more than once in their lifespan. Example, apple, mango, orange, grapevine. Then we see that breeding animals are of 2 types. The seasonal breeders, the animals which reproduce at particular periods of year, like frog, lizard, deer, etc. Then we also observe, children, that there are continuous breeders. They breed throughout their sexual maturity, like humans, monkeys, rabbit, mice, and honeybees. They breed throughout their sexual maturity. Then we see what is the chief differences between monocarpic plants and polycarpic plants. Let's enumerate them together. That flowers, they only flower once in their lifetime. This is about monocarpic plants, whereas polycarpic plants, they flower every year in particular season. Then in monocarpic plants, we see generally annual or biennial plants, very few perennials are there. Generally, there are annual or biennial plants, very few perennials are there. So, we see in polycarpic plants that only perennial plants are present. Then in monocarpic plants, we see that they die after flowering and fruiting. Whereas in polycarpic plants, they do not die after flowering and fruiting, children. Then we see in monocarpic plants, examples are rice, wheat, radish, carrot, bamboo. Whereas in polycarpic plants, the examples are apple, mango, grapevine, and orange. Now let us see what are the events that take place during sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction starts with fusion of the male and the female gametes. Then there is formation of zygote, and then there is embryogenesis, or the creation of the embryo. These sequential events may be grouped into three distinct stages, which are fertilization stage, the pre-fertilization stage, then fertilization stage, and then the post-fertilization events. Let us take these stages one by one and study in detail about them. The pre-fertilization events, all the events of sexual reproduction prior to the fusion of gametes, are referred as pre-fertilization events. What are pre-fertilization events, children? All events of sexual reproduction which occur prior or before fusion of gametes, male and female gametes, children, are referred to as pre-fertilization events. The gametogenesis and gamete transfer are two main fertilization events. What is gametogenesis? Gametogenesis is the process of gamete formation in sexually reproducing organisms. Gametes are haploid structures. In some lower organisms, both male and female gametes are produced, which are similar. They are known as isogametes. Then we see when gametes are morphologically different and distinct, then they are known as heterogametes. Then we see that the male gametes are called enthrozoites or sperm, and the female gametes are called egg or the ovum. The cell division during gamete formation. How does the cell division during gamete formation takes place? The gametes in all of two types in heterotrophic species, that is male and female gametes, are there. The gametes are haploid structures, though we see the parent body from which they arise may be either haploid or diploid. The gametes are always haploid structures. Then we see in haploid plant body, the members are monera, fungi, algae, bryophytes, which have haploid body. Whereas in diploid plant body, members of pteridophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms, and in most animals, the parent body is diploid. Then we see in haploid parent produces gametes by mitotic division. So the gametes are produced by mitotic division in haploid plants. In diploid organisms, we see specialized cells called meiosites, gamete mother cells. They undergo meiosis. This is what happens in haploid parents, in diploid organisms, we see. Then at the end of reduction division, meiotic division, it is called, only one set of chromosomes gets incorporated in each gamete. Therefore, chromosome number in meiosites or diploid is 2n, and in gametes, haploid is n of some eukaryotic organisms. In table 5, we see many of the chromosome numbers in meiosites and gametes. As you can see here, some of the plant species are Pisum sativum. The chromosome number 2N is 14, whereas the gametes, in gametes it is 7. Likewise, in other plant species like Oryza sativa, it has 24 chromosome number in meiocytes, 2N number, whereas in gametes it has 12. Then likewise, children, we see in Pyrus melius or apple, 34 is the chromosome number, whereas in gametes it's only 17. Now come to the animal species. In animal species, children, in Ascaris, we see that the chromosome number in meiocytes is 2N, whereas in gamete it is 1. Likewise, look at another animal, Musca domestica, or the common house fly. We have the number of meiocytes or chromosomes as 12, but in the gamete it is 6. Then likewise, let us see in rattus or rat, there are 42 chromosome number in the meiocytes, which is 2N, but haploid in gametes, which is 21. So these are some of the examples that we saw. Children, let's come to an important phase in reproduction called gamete transfer. When male and female gametes both must be physically brought together to facilitate fusion or fertilization. In majority of organisms, the male gamete is motile, or it is movable, and the female gamete is stationary. The male gamete needs a medium to move. In several simple plants like algae, bryophytes, and pteridophytes, water is the medium through which this gamete transfer takes place. Then we see a number of male gametes, however few to reach the female gametes. To cover this loss of male gametes, because only few reach the female gametes, during transport, the male gametes are produced in several thousands compared to the number of female gametes that are produced. So male gametes, children, are always produced in great numbers as compared to the female gametes. In some fungi and algae, both male and female gametes are motile. That means both can move. Then we see in seed plants, pollen grains are carriers of the male gametes, and ovule contains the egg in seed plants. Then we see another observation, that pollen grains produced in anthers therefore have to be transferred to the stigma before it can lead to fertilization. This event we all know is called pollination. Then the next observance in sexual reproduction is, it can be achieved by various means like anemophily. Now, what are the vectors which carry the pollen? Either the vector is anemophily, or through air. Hydrophily, that means through water the pollen is transferred. Or entomophily, with the help of insects it is transferred. Then we see chiropterophily, means through bats it is transferred. Then ornithophily, or birds, etc., it is transferred. Then we see the pollen grain germinate on stigma, and the pollen tubes carrying the male gametes reach the ovule, discharging male gametes near the eggs. What happens? Yeah, the pollen grain germinates on the stigma, children, and the pollen tube carrying the male gametes, they reach the ovule. And through micropyle, they discharge the male gametes near the egg. Then we see in lower aquatic animals like sponges and coelenterates, sperms are transferred with the help
of water. Whereas in higher animals, which are copulatory animals, they have the organ like penis to transfer the sperms in the female genital organ during copulation. So, children, these are some of the main aspects of sexual reproduction that we saw. So, children, we will conclude this video here, and we will follow on from here into how the sexual reproduction takes place in various organisms and what is the means of reproduction. So this we will see in the next video, and we will also see children the fertilization or the syngamy after the pre-fertilization understanding of reproduction. So children, wish you all the best for today. Have a good day.